Judge! Back. Judge, time! Ready? Choke!
Jay, how you stuck here? The challenger, Adriano Moraes. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. A five-time world champion, Moraes. A two-time world champion, Eustaquio. Eustaquio wants to keep it standing, employ his championship wushu striking skills. Moraes, multi-time BJJ world champion, wants to take it down. Fake there from Moraes. Both men just dipping their toes in the proverbial water here, Dragon.
They're both looking very light on their feet, just kind of feeling each other out. This is essentially round 11 between the two. Actually, no, round 8. Sorry. First one didn't go the distance.
Jab there from Eustaquio. It's been a while between drinks. This the first trilogy match in one championship history. Both men know each other so well. Both have tremendous respect for each other's talents.
See, this, I don't like seeing this from Jehei. Jehei's letting Moraes back him up into the corner. And the last time we saw Jehei get backed up in the corner, he was competing at bantamweight, and it was against Tony Taru. Tony Taru just backed him up against the corner, took him down, and choked him out. I like it when Jehei starts moving, when he gets circles out from the cage, he's sticking and moving, light on his feet, not standing statically still in front of Moraes.
Good counter overhand right there from Jehei Eustaquio. Champion telling us yesterday, I've got the power to knock Moquinho out. Moraes telling us, I'll be like a spider, just wait for Eustaquio to get caught in my web and I'll tap him out. You know that Demetrious Johnson is watching this one. He'll have to go through the Flyweight Grand Prix to get a crack at the eventual champion. Whether it's Moraes, whether it's Eustaquio, the moment still a filling out process here, Mitch.
Moraes traveled to the United States to compete in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu contests. He won the New York Open, and he also won the Naga in the black belt division during his break. So he was definitely sharpening those skills. But here his hands are looking pretty sharp.
Moraes has the reach over Eustaquio, the leg reach and the arm reach. As the speed, the pepper here at the moment, Eustaquio trying to get on the inside. Outside leaky from Moraes. Five-time world champion Moraes. Two-time world champion Eustaquio. He had more than 110 martial arts world champions here at one championship.
Good front put, rear push kick from Jehei. He was able to split the guard.
Inside leg kick from Eustaquio, pumps out the jab. They're stuck on that side of the cage, Jehei, right in front of the Team Look Guy corner. Edward Flying, Mark Sangal giving the instructions to the champion. Pump kick there from Moraes. Edging towards center cage now, both these men. Kick start. He's warming up. Kick there from Eustaquio. House kick for the lower right rib cage in Moraes. Skip up inside, full extension of the lead hand there from Eustaquio.
Moraes says he wants to be more aggressive in this, but we're not quite seeing it. We're just kind of trading these pitter-pat shots right now. Moraes hasn't even attempted a takedown yet. He's content to just keep this on the feet and trade shots with Jehei.
Glorified kickboxing contest at the moment. Eustaquio
reaching
Chuck looking through his brow. Slightly lower hands on Moraes. The more jittery of the two. Plenty of movement from Moraes. A little bit more planting of the feet from Jehei Eustaquio. Certainly the more flat footed of the two. Fake there from Moraes. Eustaquio just probing with the lead hand, trying to get his distance. Throws the right hand as Moraes came in. Jab to inside thigh kick, jab again from the champion.
I expect this. First round, Moraes is going to attempt a takedown here in the next couple, I would say next 20 seconds or so.
Most people I spoke to this week, most of the experts, believed this one would also go the distance. Now set for 5 rounds. Moraes, the more confident of the two, finishing. He's stuck where I said, I can knock Moraes out, but I believe I will win by decision. End of the first round, we go to the towels.
Interesting, I was wrong. Not even a takedown attempt in the first 5 minutes from Adriano Moraes.
Look at the scene here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Sellout in this massive arena. They've all turned out for Jay Hayes Takria. Can he take care of business against this man, Adriano Moraes?
You can just see the mutual respect shown in those first 5 minutes. They were just feeling each other out, seeing if anybody brought anything new to the table. Jay Hayes says that Moraes is a one-trick pony. All he's going to do is throw those hands, maybe a couple of kicks, shoot, and try to take me down. Moraes knows what Jay Hay wants to do. He knows that Lakai-style striking. He's been up against multiple Lakai athletes. So it'll be interesting to see if anybody's game plan changes. Both of these guys need to shift up a little bit and start putting a little bit more aggression behind themselves, because right now, dead even.
Back.
Moraes first to emerge off his stool. Here we go, second round set for five for the World Flyweight Championship. Two-time world champion Eustaquio, the five-time world champion Moraes. Philippines versus Brazil. Silence in the Mall of Asia Arena. They are waiting to erupt should Jay Hay Eustaquio land his wushu strikes, Mitch.
You can see him just waiting for that opening. Jay Hay's letting Moraes walk forward. Jay Hay's typically a counter striker. He's got a beautiful left hook, but there's the first takedown of the match. Beautifully timed. He found his moment. Led Jay Hay to believe that he was going to strike with him. Slid underneath for that double leg and pins him up against the cage. This is where Moraes excels. He didn't have that same opportunity to utilize the cage when they competed in the ring last time. Now Moraes has the opportunity, but he is turning him away from the cage, so Jay Hay's not able to use the cage to walk back up.
Fantastic little half-guard position, trying to pry that leg open there, Adriano Moraes. Eustaquio having to work off his back. Not the preferred position for Eustaquio. He said to us yesterday, I'm unfazed by any of the ground game of Moraes.
Watch out, buckle the head.
He's taken Moraes' best submission attempt in two matches so far.
Beautiful job by Jay Hay to dig with the underhooks, scoot onto his side.
Oh, punch the back, there's Moraes. Gonna take him for a ride. That's Moraes against the cage. Here come the right hands from the challenger. Scooping in the uppercuts. Right in the back of Jay Hay Eustaquio.
Jay Hay's got to be careful in this position. Watch, Adriano Moraes is going to slowly start to adjust his position. He's a little bit too far on the right side. So Jay Hay has got to try to, first he's got to break that grip. See how Adriano Moraes has his legs triangled and one leg is laced underneath there? It's going to help him secure this position. It's hard to finish when your opponent is standing up like this. It's hard, but it also takes a lot of leg strength as well.
An illegal blow to the back of the head with the elbow. A warning there from referee Olivier Cox. Still on the back. Is this more training on Moraes or more training on Eustaquio?
Well, I would assume the years of experience that Moraes has, he's going to be fine in a lot of these positions. He's very, he has stamina. And he goes underneath him.
Jay Hay
tries to turn the corner on it, but he gives up Does it better than most. Beautiful, look at this, how he turns in. He's able to end up on top from a bad position to a good one. Very impressive.
Third round of five.
Yes, back, back,
Jay Hayes stuck here.
Jay,
the two-time and defending flyweight world champion. Also a Philippine national wushu champion. Adriano Moraes, the five-time one flyweight world champion. And also a multiple BJJ world champ. What a back and forth contest. A brilliant second stanza. Nice, low sweeping leg kick there from Eustaquio. So relaxed, so fluid, the champion, and he's striking. Resets again here. Oh, nicely done. Jump balking right hand there from Eustaquio. And hands cocked and ready. And he sucker Moraes in. Catches the high kick. Jab doubles up with the lead hand as he's stuck here.
Jay's okay to get pushed up against the cage like that. Almost rope-a-dope, actually, trying to wait for Moraes to expend some energy so he can come back and counter.
Good outside low kick, flip the turn. Hits him Moraes to the punch here. Moraes may be starting to get a little frustrated by the strikes landing. Goes to the outside lead side as the challenger. Know that Eustaquio will not tire. If there's one thing that Team Lakai has, it's cardio for days. Training up in those extreme altitudes of Baguio City. Tries to counter off the low kick to Jay Eustaquio.
What's the altitude out there, Michael Schmello?
I think it's around 6,000 feet, Mitch.
You said it last week.
I did.
Just under 5,000 feet of elevation.
Did you ask me that if you knew already?
I was checking.
Still a striking contest here in the third of five. Good outside leg kick from Eustaquio. Just dropping it on top of the lead knee of Moraes. Body shot to the stern. Moraes has got to get some strikes off of his own now. That took from Eustaquio. Moraes telling us yesterday, Mitch, I don't want this to go to a decision in Manila. And he needs to do a whole lot more. He needs to start getting aggressive. Look for a way to get the champion on his back.
Because right now, Jay Hayes letting go of some serious hand combinations. He's countering Moraes' attacks very well, especially on that hook. You can see a little bit of damage that Jay Hayes wearing a little bit, but it's not affecting him too much. Moraes has got to turn this up. He's got to start putting Jay Hay onto his back, creating those scrambles, dominate from the top position. He's not winning the striking exchanges here.
He Big hello to another world champion here at one who is watching live, the great Bibiano Fernandez. He's cheering on his compatriot Adriano Moraes. Roundhouse kick there from Eustaquia. Single leg lock up from Moraes. What can he do with it here? The Brazilian.
You see him transition to a double, turn the corner and then go after the double. Ah, but Jehe was able to maintain that balance and keep it on his feet.
Jab to body shot from Eustaquia. It's been a bread and butter combination for the Filipino. Skip up front kick from him. High right round kick. Eustaquia loves up high. Throws the uppercut. Almost takes out a ring light. Back to center cage from Moraes. Eustaquia goes to the body. Both sides of the carcass. Skips forward now the champion. Backing up Moraes momentarily. Front kick, Moraes swings wildly with a looping left hand. Roundhouse kick, found the elbow. It can be painful if you land a kick to an opponent's elbow. And hurt your instep, the top of your foot, gotta be careful. Outside leg kick from Eustaquia, 1 minute five remaining, Mitch, third of five.
Well, Moraes is gonna have to do something here, extremely impressive, to inch this round his way, because right now, Eustaquio is counter-striking brilliantly.
Eustaquio a little frustrated with himself. Checks the low kick. Moraes, full extension on the jab.
The jab looked nice.
And again, time to bring the right hand over the top of Eustaquio's left shoulder. Little cut on the bridge of the nose, it looks like. The champion's the entrance. Under 30 seconds remains now. This entire round has mostly been a striking contest. Gives the lead hand down the body, does Eustaquio, gets out of the way of the high left roundhouse. They're going to go down to the towels at the end of three.
Once again.
Overhand right, left hook, nothing connecting. More to the uppercut from Eustaquio. We are moving in to deep water. Everybody in the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. We had to turn back a lot of people at the door tonight. Unfortunately, this huge arena can only hold so many, and it is packed out. Mitch, how do you see it?
Interesting third round. We saw a lot of scrambles. The first round was kind of null. The second round was a lot of grappling, a lot of scrambles. Very entertaining second round. The third round, a little bit more back and forth action, but we saw the counter striking of Jehe start to do more damage, start touching up Adriano. But Adriano was able to find that jab. He was able to utilize the jab to start piecing up Jehe. So it's interesting to now to get into those championship rounds. Now we're into deep water. How are these guys going to move forward? Because right now it's pretty close.
We move in to the business end of this world title match. Jehe Eustaquia, two-time world champion. Adriano Moraes, a five-time world champion. As I look at the trends on Philippines Twitter at the moment, interestingly, Moraes is trending on Twitter here in the Philippines. Skip up roundhouse kick from the challenger. Moraes for the loss to Eustaquio last time, and one fall on the trot, including over Eugene Takiro. Tilik Batyarov, Karen Akhmatov, and the King, Danny Kingad, tapping up the King in only the first round with a rear naked choke. Has fared well against Filipinos. Adriano Moraes. Pick up the pace here against Jehe Eustaquio. Eustaquio is such an unassuming world champion. A real rocky story here at one championship. Quiet spoken, mild mannered. He can be ferocious inside the cage.
He's so humble. He's also developing a little bit of cockiness. He's got a little bit of cockiness to him now. He's putting on that swagger of being the world champion, and with good reason. He's starting to put together some good combinations in this fourth round. Adriano's starting to push forward and do some work on his own, though.
A short left hand there. Mitch, when you know your opponent so well, when you've competed against each other so many times before, How do you change it up here? How do you change levels, change directions to do something the other doesn't expect?
You'd think that, you know, Adriano would try to take this more to his strength. He seems content to sit here and exchange shots in the fourth round where he might be in behind in some of the scorecards.
So in what we're seeing, which is a striking battle predominantly, do you think Jay Hay is having the upper hand?
He's connecting a little bit more on the counter shots. He is countering a little bit more effectively. You can start to see, you know, Adriano is the one moving forward. He's showing the aggression, but I think Adriano is landing with, or Jay Hay is landing with a little bit more emphasis.
Elbow there from Eustachio came agonizingly close to shaving off the eyebrow. The body shot there from Moraes. Returns the favorite as the champion. Fakes downstairs, goes upstairs. Lead left hook from Eustachio doesn't connect. And the Wushu champion resets himself. Nice skip up inside the leg kick. And again, in that single profunda.
I like when Jay Hay's moving forward. He's starting to show aggression. Because when he's allowing Adriano to dictate it, oh, but a nice duck under, takes the back.
Oh, this is more like it. This is Moraes' world. This is Adrianoville. He's got the back of the champion. And he's going for a ride again. What can Eustachio do from here, Dragon?
Well, he's trying to shake him off the backside, but he chooses to stand back up. You can see, watch, Adriano's going to triangle his legs together, snake one leg underneath the legs there. Now we're back to where we were in the beginning of the second round.
Moraes said he'd be like a spider. Is Eustachio stuck in the web here? It looks like a demented game of Twister. A submission attempt from Adriano Moraes. Referee Olivia goes right on top of the action. Have a look at this.
Oh.
Oh, my word. Have a look at this.
The body is not supposed to bend that way.
What pain may Eustachio be in? His face isn't showing it. The flexibility of the champion. I've never seen this before. How do you get out of it? A spider's web. This is amazing. Have a look at this sub attempt. What do you call it, man?
Look at him, he's trying to knee bar. That's basically a rear naked knee bar. I think he's what he's trying to do. He's got that leg triangle around the body. Jay Hay's got to try to release that triangle leg. So he's got to try to release the right leg of Adriano. Adriano's trying to crank on that leg. He's almost near a banana split if he takes the other leg and breaks that right leg over there. But man,
I don't want to know what's the split. All I know is this is awesome. This is crazy. It's a mess of legs and arms. But now Eustachio's free. But what effect did it take on the champion's left leg? You've got to wonder on the hamstring, on the knee, on the gastrocnemius muscle. What effect did it take on Jay Hay Eustachio?
Gastrocnemius is the calf muscle for all you people out there. But that was an interesting submission move. But look at Jay, he's getting him on top.
Have a look at this. Back onto his feet.
Oh, look at
the leg. Go nuts again.
The leg almost came out. Look at him. He can barely put weight on that leg.
A little limp there from Eustachio. Goes back to his corner. That was one of the most inventive submissions we've ever seen from Moraes. And they go to work. They go to work straight away on the left leg of Eustachio in his corner. What effect did it have on the leg of Eustachio? I believe the doctor's in the corner of Jay Hay looking over the left leg. It's taken damage.
So apparently this submission is called a Suliov stretch. Look at the way he's triangled the body, pulling that leg into deep. He's trying to take the leg completely off the body right there. So much torque was applied, and you could just see the way Jay Hay couldn't put pressure on that leg. How is it gonna affect him in this round?
The Suliov stretch. That's what we believe the submission is called. Fifth and final round, the championship round.
I think we need to call it the Moraes Mangler, because
again, very ginger on that left leg is Jay Hay Eustachio.
Moraes should go right after that leg and just start laying into the leg kicks.
I agree. Just kick it all night long now. Let's see how it holds up for the champion. All Moraes comes out jabbing. There's the right idea to that common peroneal move just above the lead knee.
Now, was that close to a near submission? You gotta believe it was. Jay gave the thumbs up, but
it looked to me at one stage like his hamstring had to snap.
So instead of keeping Jay on his feet, Elias may want to take him down. You know, he's not gonna be able to scramble the same way. He's not gonna be able to move the same on the ground. Start laying into leg kicks. Don't stand there and box with him.
This crowd, this sellout crowd in Manila, expectant of the champion. 1 minute down in the final round, four to go. We are scoring on an overall contest, not round by round. Jab two, then a hook from the champion, Eustaquio. Jab two again down the center corridor, then goes to the outside leg, throws the right hand lead. Looking for a takedown, gets a takedown to Moraes. Now let's see the survival skills. Let's see the defense from Eustaquio. He's back to his feet!
Interesting how Jay is able to try to, he kind of shrimps out or hip escapes out. And it's like he's going for a kimura on the side, but he utilizes that hip position to create that scramble and to get up.
Jay Hay glances up at the big screen. Tries to thread the left hand over the top. 3 minutes, 10 remaining. Moraes backs off. They reset center cage. Jab two again from Eustaquio. Checks the low kick. Does the champion, the two-time world champion Eustaquio, the five-time world champion Moraes, and he drives Eustaquio onto the canvas. Top position for the challenger Moraes.
Nice double leg there from Moraes. Now he's got to be careful because watch, Jay Hayes, if he gets back into half guard, he's going to try that same awkward sit-up. See how he tries to overhook the head and then move his body out to the side. And there he creates a little bit of movement, but he doesn't do it well in half guard. He doesn't do it well in full guard. He does it well in half guard position. So he keeps trying to do that, overhook the head and then create space on that one side. See, he does it. So he overhooks the head and then he starts to hip escape out. In half guard, it works very well, but not so well in full guard. Adriano's got to catch on to that and keep him in this position. He might try to advance and step over, and Jay might let him go in half guard just so he can get out again.
2 minutes remain to the fifth and final round. Still has Moraes inside the guard, closes the guard now. Looking for the elbow into this. Collarbone of the challenger. Elbow from Moraes. A chance go up. Jay Hay. Oh, nice push off from the champion. Look out for the up kicks here. Moraes has got to be careful. Those heels flying towards his jaw. Is he going to allow Eustaquio back to his feet? No, he won't. Goes inside the guard.
Smart move on Moraes' part. You can see Jay Hayes trying to overhook the head, trying to hip escape out. But he's not looking to come
out. Under a minute remaining. Who's going to dig deep? Who's going to go into the well? The intestinal fortitude. Who's got the gusto? Who's got the pepper? Who's got the fuel in the tank to bring it home to capture flyweight gold? And look, he's back here, Eustaquio. And down goes Moraes again, inside the Filipino's guard.
Now Moraes is in half guard, so look for two. He can escape out and create that scramble. Moraes has got to apply a lot of top pressure, not allow Jay Hay to create that little bit of space.
This has been an amazing world title bout. It has been one to remember. The first ever trilogy match in one championship history. Moraes in half guard. Is he going to finish the contest here? Both men trying the body shots. We're going down the judges in Manila. Time. Both men think They've won it.
Look at Jay Hay slipping through the guard, letting the 1-2 go. But then Adriano Moraes does what he does. Slides under the punch combination, secures the double leg, traps those legs, puts Jay Hay down, and that was how we ended the match. Back and forth action on both sides. Do you give it to Jay Hay and his superior striking, or do you give it to Adriano Moraes and his grounding control and possible near submission with the Moraes Mangler? I don't know how to say the other words, so I'm gonna call it the Mangler.
Chatri Sitchatong, founder of One Championship, to present the belt, to put it around the waist of either Jay Hayestaglio or Adriano Moraes. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries, how did you score it? Sellout crowd. We know who they want to win. The sportsmanship between these two have etched their names again into the annals of immortality.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new one flyweight world champion, Adriano Moraes.
We have a new champion. Adriano Moraes reclaims the flyweight gold. What a moment here for the Brazilian. Devastation for Eustaquio. Jubilation for Moraes. The rain of gold over the cage. The rain of gold for Adriano Moraes yet again.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome One Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.